Okay, welcome. This is the second interaction for today. This is an interaction for Moodle, which was covered in week 5. So, I'm not really an expert on Moodle, but I'll do my best to answer any questions that you have. So, I'll be waiting here for any hand raises from your side. Yes, center 1345.
Very good morning, sir.
Good morning.
And currently my question is about the quiz 7. In this quiz 7, question 6 is little bit, the topic that has been addressed in this particular question is not very much clear, I guess. I don't think so. We have discussed about the certainty-based marking system in any of our previous videos or in any of our lectures. So we would like to get more clarity to answer that particular question, I guess. Of course, we have seen few particular information about the CBM marking scheme. Rather than that, we would like to get few more elaboration on that particular marking scheme so that we can mark perfect answer for that.
Okay. So, the question was regarding the certainty based marking. Actually, I did touch upon this topic in the last video on setting up the quizzes. So, that is before the miscellaneous topics that I covered. So, there was a topic on setting up quizzes where I did show a small example of CBT. What I would really like you to do is not only go to this site, but today also that we will try to hold an exercise where we will ask you to go to demo.moodle.net and make your own quiz. So that assignment will be given to you sometime later. The key thing in certainty based marking is the following, and hopefully it will help you. So I think I had mentioned that it was 10 questions and 1 point per question possible. So, that is a regular quiz that someone has set. Now, in certainty based marking, you need to choose options. Normally, there are 3 options that you are very confident, semi-confident or not so confident. And if you mark wrong and also are very confident about the answer, then you get negative marks heavily, okay, and in between you get some slight negative marks. And if you are very sure that you are marking correct and definitely your answer is correct and your confidence level is also high on that, then you get actually more than 1 marks. And I think I had expected that it would be 4, because on some site it was 4, but most cases say that on Moodle, they expect 3 marks for a very confident right answer. It does not matter. The principle was, if you see, I gave all marks between 0 and 10 except for 2 people who got plus 40 and minus 60. So, obviously, one of them was extremely confident and totally wrong, and the other guy was extremely confident and totally correct. So, my expectation is that you go over the results or the options given try to eliminate the ones which are certainly not applicable, because everything is just a possibility. Okay. For example, someone getting 10 could have got 10 in many ways. He could have got 2 places where it was extremely right and he was confident too, and then 2 questions where he was not so confident but marked it right. So, he would have got 4, 4 and 2. But there is a possibility that that person could have marked all 10 questions correct, but he was not totally confident about it. So, he just gets 1 mark, which is the regular scheme, which is, so if you are totally not confident, it is the regular scheme, the regular quiz. That is what the certainty CBT, if you go anywhere, that is what they will tell you about CBT, that if you are least confident, it is like the regular quiz. That is, you get plus 1 for a right answer and 0 for a wrong answer. Whereas the moment you start becoming slightly confident, you get more marks if you are right and more confident, and you get negative marks if you are wrong and still confident that your answer was right. So based on this, just eliminate the answers which are definitely not possible. It is definitely possible that, you know, some of the answers you may feel are definitely right or could be right. So you can mark these, I don't mind it, and we will check whether such a thing is possible. But according to me, I thought that I had put in three answers which were more or less possible. Of course, not the answer where the instructor doesn't know the marking scheme, okay. That was not really, that was just put in there. But of course, I expected that that participants would actually go out and figure out what CBT would be. And you should realize that if you are totally not confident and you mark it as such, it is like a regular quiz. Otherwise, you get more marks or less marks. So you have to just choose, try to eliminate the ones which are definitely not correct. I think that if you follow that principle, hopefully you should come up to the right answers. Thank you.
Hello.
Yes.
Yeah, sir. I have like a few queries and like a few a reminder. First thing, in our last face-to-face meeting, it was told that IIT will provide us lots of like books and papers related to all Bloom's taxonomy and all that thing. So that resource is still pending. So we would like to go through it. Another thing is that there are so many like Bloom's taxonomy, then revised Bloom's taxonomy, there are so many models. So is there any kind of like a paper or something where they have compared those different models and then they would like to go through it? It will also help to us. So these are like two main reminder or like a query. And another thing is that in discussion forum right now, we have to log in the computer and then we have to check all this one. So is it possible that any kind of like a tool will be provided to us which can help us to have interface with our mobile phone, because on mobile phone we are always with connected with this thing. So if there is any query or something, so you know, immediately we can reply to it, or I mean more convenient with the mobile phone rather than like our desktop computer. That is one thing. And then we also feel that thing like in earlier stage, the justification was given for each and every answer, but now later on in the quiz part, justification is not given. If the justification is given, we will also understand what is the point of view of a quiz designer. Third thing about the team assignments. So in team assignments, we would like to know how to basically form a team. And then is there any possibility, let's say a few our of colleagues are not actually enrolled into this course, but we wanted to take them and form a team outside of this course, and then we can form our team and submit our assignment. So can it be considered? So these are some of the queries and like a reminder. So my colleague also wants to comment on something.
Good morning, sir. My question is based on the certainty-based marking system. It's in continuation with the question asked by the previous resource. So it mentioned that if I choose a confident level, that is C3, you mentioned about the incentive marks that I get, that is plus 4, right? Mm-hmm. Now, what happens if I make a mistake? How much marks would then I lose? Minus, or is it minus 6?
Okay, so let me do this. So coming to the first question that the other person asked, unfortunately, I am not too aware of this. What is going to happen is Professor Fatak will come here at 12:15, and some of the course related questions you can ask. And definitely the point that the feedback must be given, I think that I will convey to the other instructors. And regarding resources, I assume this is regarding week 3 and 4. So again, I will try to pass this on to the relevant instructor, who probably is going to hold a session tomorrow anyway. So maybe you can save these questions again to ask the relevant instructor. And regarding groups formation and taking people from outside, I think it is best if you ask Professor Fatak, because these are rules regarding the course, and then it is best that he, you know, he tells what is okay or not okay, because I am not really deciding the rules here. Now, regarding certainty based marking, the thing is that if you are not confident, okay, and if you mark the answer correct, you get plus 1. If you don't mark it correct, you get 0. But let us say you mark something, some answer, and you say that you are extremely confident, that is, you mark the highest level of confidence, okay. And I think the current Moodle sites give you 3 levels, though I think I saw some site where they actually gave you around 4 levels. If you mark the highest level, and if the answer is correct, then you get incentive marks, which means, let's say, you get, I think the standard says that you get 3 instead of 1 mark. And if you actually get, if the answer is wrong and you are very confident that the answer is right, then the system is trying to tell you that you are actually confident about the wrong things. I mean, you don't know what is going on and still you are marking something and very confident about it. So it penalizes you, and the penalty is normally double. So you get minus 6 marks at the highest confidence level, and minus 4 and so on. So I think it is minus 6, minus 3 and 0 if for the 3 confidence level, and 1, 2 and 4 if you are confident and the answer is right. Roughly, I think that is the scheme, but that you will have to check. So I wanted again people to go ahead and check the schemes that are available for confidence or certainty based marking. So I think if you are very confident and the answer is right, you should get 3, and if you are very confident and the answer is wrong, actually you will get minus 6. So I hope that answers.
Hello sir, good morning. My name is Poonam Deshpande. Your videos on Moodle were very informative. My question is regarding the quizzes and the questions asked in those quizzes. Mm-hmm. Sometimes the questions are very confusing. Like for example, the first question in week 5's quiz, that is regarding the, I think, default format. So it was not mentioned the default format for IITB Moodle. So when actually we went to check around what the answer can be, so we got some other answer, and I got, it was not correct. My answer was topics. So actually we were supposed to answer with respect to IIT Moodle. So is it possible to make these questions more specific?
Can I interject here? So it is possible that the default format somewhere is topics, and if you actually give us reasonable evidence on it, we will actually mark even that as the correct answer. So please do not believe that, you know, just because you think now you have marked it wrong, we will mark it wrong, okay. But I need a reasonable proof. You show me places where topics is the default answer. So I need a proof on that, okay, because most places I have looked, it was always weeks which was the default setting. So if you think you can show it to me by proof, then I think we'll consider that answer. And it is good, because I really wanted you again to go ahead, check the net and tell me what possibilities exist. So it's not a very hard and fast thing, but you need to give a proof.
When we explored, we found that majority of the sites, especially the official site of Moodle, the default setting that comes down is topics first.
Okay. So fine. You please send.
Marks.
And according to the video, it is 4. And for giving a wrong answer, it is 6. So that is the confusion that we have.
Okay,
so if at one, on the one hand, you're giving plus 4 for a correct answer, then you should be deducting minus 8 for the wrong answer.
Okay.
But the person is getting minus 60.
Okay. So I hope the question is over. If you realize again in the certainty based marking, I agree that, you know, plus 4, minus 8 would have been a good way of putting it together. But if you see the marks that I have allotted to students, except for 2 students, everyone is between 0 and 10. So obviously one person is being very confident and getting it right, and the other person is very confident but everything is wrong. So that is the only thing I really wanted you to, you know, get out of it. I mean, there was no insistence that, you know, it did not matter if I had said plus 30 or plus 40. I mean, it wouldn't have changed any of the answers that were given below. So I think that way I am not too keen on changing the wordings or the marks in that question, because there should not be too much confusion regarding it. However, the point regarding topics is well taken. I think if by default the site says it should be topics, then I will have that answer definitely marked correct. So because you are showing me proof that, you know, that was by far the most default way of putting up Moodle. So I don't mind that answer being marked correct. Thank you.
Sir, there's one more question related to this only. Is the marking scheme decided by the instructor and selected, or is it by default? What is there? Can it be decided by the instructor, the marking scheme?
Yes. Like, for example, that is the whole idea. If you are setting a quiz, you can set the type of questions and you can set the kind of quiz also, whether it's a certainty based marking scheme, everything you can set. So the moment, in fact, that is the exercise we are going to tell you to do in the afternoon to set up a quiz. You will realize that you can actually do all of this. And that is what I had maybe showed slightly in the videos, that you can actually go, you know, and create a quiz, okay, and you can choose the marking scheme that you want. Yes, COEP.
Sir, my question is regarding a Moodle submission. In that case, suppose 60 numbers of students submitting their assignment. So in that case, how you can check the duplication, means plagiarism? Is there any inbuilt facility in Moodle?
As far as I know, I don't think there is an inbuilt facility right now. What we used to do, at least for my course, what I used to do was I would download all the assignments and use web-based resources to check for plagiarism. So that is what I used to do. I do not think Moodle has it, but then, you know, maybe a newer version has it, then I don't know. But what we used to do, I am telling you, we would just download it and use a web-based resource to do it.
Okay. Sir, one thing, can we have the interface, means in that case we can have that external plagiarism checker to that. Is there any facility?
Or
we have to download and that is okay?
No, I didn't get it. You want to, what kind of interface do you want?
Means external plagiarism, we have the most of the website, they are checking the plagiarism.
Correct.
So in that case, can we make that interface with Moodle? Is this any facility like this?
Okay, I think I still didn't get your question. You want it, so because if you open a side window for opening such a resource, you can use it. But if you want it to open through Moodle, we can always give a URL, because that is one of the possibilities, that we can add it in Moodle itself, a URL site to one of such places where you can check for plagiarism. Is that what you are asking for? I am not very clear really.
Yes sir, yes, I am asking the same thing.
Okay, so what I will do is I will pass this on to the administrators and see if they can put up such a link on the Moodle site for this course.
Hello.
Yes.
Am I audible?
Yes.
Sir, I have a question about the quizzes. When we are talking about the quiz, like there are different domains, and it would be very preferable that if we get the quizzes according to the domains. And second is, there is a confusion between the markings of the correct answer and the wrong answer, like how many marks are going to be deducted. There is a confusion there. So my humble suggestion is that as far as our domains are concerned, it will be very nice if we get the quizzes according to our domains. Thank you.
Let me ask, so what do you really imply by quizzes according to the domain? Because most quizzes are as per what was being taught in that week. And as far as I know, none of the quizzes have any negative marking that we have set up in this. If it is there, it will be explicitly told. So right now you have only 1 or 0 marks. If there is any negative marks, that would be explicitly mentioned. So I don't think there are any negative marks right now, but let me confirm with the other instructors too regarding negative marks for quizzes.
This is about negative marks, and what are the exact marks for the correct answer?
So that is being mentioned. For example, the quiz that I have set on Moodle, I make it, it is explicitly written after every question whether 1 point is possible or 2 points are possible or 3 points are possible, and there are no negative marks. And as far as I know, all the other quizzes have exactly the same pattern. So I thought it was explicit, but still let me confirm with the other instructors as to what kind of quizzes they have set. Thank you. Yes, 1041.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you for calling. Sir, I just came to know about this concept of CVM from your brief lecture, and I also searched on the internet about this. What I understand from the CVM concept that it is necessary to know the confidence level of the student also while evaluating his grade. So in your question, you have given the total marks. And what I understand from the marks, that it can range from minus 60 to 40, and incidentally, both cases are included in the question. My question is not directed to this particular question, but general in nature. Sir, how we interpret the data without knowing the confidence level? For example, if a student have scored 15 marks or 20 marks or 30 marks, let us avoid the extreme cases. So what does it interpret? Suppose a student has got 20 marks. So what should I think about that student? Whether he has guessed or not like this? Because I am very much interested about the CVM, because this concept will at least reduce the copying, which is very very common problem among the students. So I would like to know your comment, how to interpret the total numbers without knowing the confidence level of the student.
So I will try to give my interpretation of what I think. So if I set 10 questions for 1 mark each, and just give 0 or 1 marks for every question, which is what I had mentioned in that quiz question also, then the marks would have been only between 0 and 10. Now if someone is getting far negative marks, like minus 20 or minus 30, it, not the extreme also, let us say, it means that at least for, you know, 4 or 5 questions, he's marking, or he or she is marking the wrong answer, but still is very confident that the answer is right. Okay, if you start getting negative marks, it means you are very confident about wrong concepts. So you think that I have understood this material really well, and but the, you know, the answer is wrong. That means, you know, you are confident about the wrong things. So you really need to look out for people who are getting into the negative marks to figure out what is it that they have understood wrong. Because, you know, in any class, you will find at least a reasonable set of students, I would put it at around 20%, who think that they have understood it, everything right, and yet, you know, that is not what is right. So that is, you know, you will at least figure out, you know, what kind of wrong concepts are coming in. And definitely the guys who are getting much more positive, you know, let us say 10 would have been just the limit if everyone got 1 and 0. If they are getting much more positive, like more than 20, you know that at least for a reasonable set of questions, they are marking the answer right and they are very confident about it. And these are the students who have really figured out what is going on, because they know the answer is right and they are very confident about it. And of course, there are others who roughly know that what the formula should be, you know, and somewhere they have calculated, they are marking the answers right, but they are not yet so confident to tell you, I am very confident about it. So those are the people who will probably get, you know, between 0 and 10. You know, they will never try to mark that I am very confident, because they immediately know that the penalty for a wrong answer is minus 6 times. So they will definitely be very, very careful in marking their certainty. So those sets of people, maybe you can, you know, people who get between 0 and 10 are the guys who probably, at least between 5 and 10, let us say, they know reasonable stuff, but they are not too confident and their concepts need to be, you know, told, okay, what are you not really confident about? Okay, so that is the set which probably will, you know, cross the bridge if you provide them extra coaching. Whereas the guys who are really confident, probably they know what to do, and so, you know, okay, if you really want to teach them further for something else, that is okay. So you know which group probably needs to be addressed in what fashion. I mean, the students getting between 5 and 10 on such a quiz, probably, you know, you need to figure out why they are not so confident, but yet they seem to be getting their answers right. Or is it just guesswork because they are just guessing and they don't want to give a totally confident, you know, appraisal that I am very confident, because they know they have guessed it and they don't want to be very confident because they will get a negative mark on it, or that too, a very heavily negative mark on it. So you have to find out who is doing guesswork, who knows stuff but not confident, and there are people who don't know stuff but they still think they are extremely confident about it. So at least that kind of differentiation, you can at least maybe put it in two or three baskets, you know, this is the kind of students who are very confident and they know the right answer and very confident about it. Then there is a set who is marking wrong answers, but they seem to be very sure that they know that this is correct. So these are people who, you know, are understanding things wrong. Then there are people who are doing guesswork, and then there are people who are probably, they know somewhat what to do, but they are not too confident, and you need to figure out how you can bring their confidence up, or what is it that they have not slightly understood about the topic. So this is my interpretation of how you can actually use the certainty based marking scheme. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
So my question is that if I want to establish a Moodle page for my college, so it needs to be installed on a server.
Yes.
So who will be providing all the facility? Like, it will be monitored by IIT Bombay, or should I involve my university in it?
No, so Moodle is something which is there to help you. So all you need is a good computer and turn it into a server, and as long as it can run Moodle and handle a bit of participants, I think every department or at least the university or your college should have a Moodle server. So it's up to your computer administrator to be good enough to download the open source software for it and, you know, make it running. So there is no one else who's going to monitor it. It is for your own good that you should be having such a thing on yourself. So it's going to be your responsibility.
Good morning, sir. My question is regarding peer assessment process. Actually, I got 4 good reviews out of 5, and 1 review was a no work. So how my grade affect in peer assessment process?
Okay, so this is something which I know less about, but I can tell you something that you have marks for submission and you have marks for assessing others, and your marks, of course, for your submission will be based in some combination of the reviews that you got. So if most of the reviews you got were good, your average review is actually good, so you may actually end up with a reasonably good mark. But it also, there are some marks which are assigned to how you have reviewed other people, and again this is compared with the average rating that particular assignment has got. So if the average is, let us say, low and you are the only person marking high, then it is possible that you will not get the best marks for reviewing someone's assignment. But this is going to be a combination of many factors, depending on what others have also put in for that particular assignment. Now, I don't think you should be overly worried about this. The overall percentage of marks which are reserved for peer review is at least for the first 70% of the total grade, it's barely 10%, okay, 10 to 12%. So I don't think you should be you should be concerned about it. In the fact, I should say that you should try to learn from it. If someone has given you a bad review, if you think try to see if there are points which are definitely worth considering. So I would say that you take it as a learning process. So don't just neglect what people have written.
Definitely, sir. Thank you.
Okay, sir, while going through the Moodle activities, I have found that it is same like Blackboard LMS which we use at our school. The problem over here is that we find very less less students participating in the discussion forum. So how to activate and motivate them?
Okay, this is a reasonably tricky question. A lot of times we put so many resources on Moodle and find that students are not really logging in and checking it, and they don't seem to be bothered. So I think one of the ways in which you try to ensure that they log on and check Moodle is, you put up some activity which makes them go to Moodle and then answer a short quiz then and there, which is part of the grade. So that is one of the ways in which you can do it. In fact, it's possible to load activities where, based on, they see something, they answer, then you ask a question, and based on that answer, let's say you have to be reasonably clever in setting up such questions. You can actually set up questions that, based on their answers, let us say you have three options, you actually make them search somewhere else and come up with a further question. So you actually make them be reasonably active by forcing them to go to a particular site, forcing them to log on to Moodle, and so on. So I think that is the only way. The moment you, if the learning is not their main motive, then you have to force them to learn. That is very unfortunate, but that's how it is.
Okay, sir, thank you. One more question with relation to peer assessment. Mm-hmm. Will that going to affect a lot on our grades?
No, I think I have also asked other people, and do not worry too much about it. It will not affect your past grade so much. So the only thing is, you must be submitting your assignments. That is far more important than worrying about the peer assessment. So I think that is the only take home point that has been told to be given.
Sir, a last request. There are so many discussions which happens where we ask our staff members to assist or the organizers to assist, but we do not get the replies even in one day. Sir, kindly requesting you to please submit some reply so that we are clear of.
Okay, so you are saying that there are many requests for which you have not got any replies. Is that the...
Yes, there were some queries which were posted, and we were continuously requesting for staff to assist us on the same.
Okay, so I'll put this down. So did you put this on the IIT Bombay X site itself?
This was on the discussion forum,
sir. Okay,
and
yeah,
this
sure,
was regarding
sure.
the queries.
So yeah, actually, if you realize that, the amount of participants we are handling right now probably is slightly more for us. There are around 4,000 participants, and we don't have as much staff really, but we will try to do our best. So I will just pass this also on to the other team members and Professor Fatak. Okay, thank you.
Good morning, sir.
Yes, good morning.
Sir, one more question is about the learning objectives. When we are making the questions, for getting an answer, we have to use the learning objectives. For a particular learning objective, we are making the questions, right, sir?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
We can make two questions for the same learning objective.
Okay.
When a student answering for the first question, he is answering the right answer, he is taking the right answer, and for the second, he is taking the wrong answer.
Okay.
At that time, how can we realize, or how can we get the assessment that he is getting that learning objective?
So I would say that it of course depends, such a set of consecutive questions always depends on how skillfully the questions are set. So if the second question really follows up very well on the first question, and if you have understood the first question right, it is hoped that that concept is clear, and the next concept hopefully you should be knowing. So if that is not clear, then you know till what point the student has learnt or not learnt. So if right at the first moment you are not clear, then you can actually have, of course, a different question which will try to see, okay, if you don't know so much, do you know at least so much? Okay. So, I think if you want to test students out, you try to see till what level they have figured out. If they don't, if they know till a certain level, then you need to ask a certain higher level and so on, and stop at the point where they don't seem to know any further. And then you can figure out, or then you can try to bunch students up into the levels that, you know, they seem to have reached. This is how I would look at learning objectives. Again, I would say that you should put this question again to Professor Sahana Murthy, who has probably taught you this section.
One more thing is the password and username can be shared to anyone. So when we are using this Moodle, a good student can help. Actually, it is not helping, but help all the peers. Like he know the answer and he is answering all the questions by using not the password and username of his own, but the other students or other fellows. At that time, how can we measure the how can we assess the class? Because the questions are answered by only one person.
Okay,
so
you don't even need to share the name and password if you want to cheat. Okay, for example, we give reasonable amount of time to people. Okay, so in that case, you know, I can just sit with you, figure out what you are answering, and come back 5 minutes later to my computer and just mark the correct answers, and I'm done with it. So, if the objective is to cheat, I realize that things are going to be very difficult. So, one of the ways, I mean, unfortunately, this is how it is. And if you trust the students, then you can let them do everything in their hostel rooms. Okay. And, one of the ways to get around this is to have, laptops on in the class and hold the quiz in the class for a fixed duration and have questions which are randomly different for everyone. For example, there are types of questions where I can have the answers or, you know, the values put in different for everyone else. And not only that, I can have, the settings such that, you know, only particular IP numbers can get a certain kind of question. So, those extra settings are also possible. I am not totally aware of it, but such things can also be done. Okay. But one of the things I would say is do it in class. Have it monitored and ensure that everyone gets a randomly different set of values. That would definitely, probably at least reduce the kind of cheating that you are talking about.
Hello, good afternoon, sir.
Yes, good afternoon.
Yeah, we have been following all the activities and thank you very much for making us aware of this very good tool, screencasting, with which we can reach to more students. My question is, hello. Yeah. Is there any facility in the Moodle wherein we can send messages or alert whenever we upload an assignment or a quiz to the participants, automatically being sent because they are again remote and we cannot have a communication with them formally?
Yeah,
so is there any facility in the Moodle to
activate? So especially assignments, etc. There is a mail which can be sent immediately, but you must realize, you know, that students also have a capability of not getting every mail, but a bunch of mail at the end of the week. So, even if you send out a mail immediately, it is not necessary that the students will get it. So, they should not, you know, change their settings such that they will get it in a week, in which case you can hardly do anything. So, normally I will ask the students that they ought to not change any of these settings where they receive, some kind of email from us or some kind of a message from us. So, I would normally just upload an assignment and immediately go to the discussion forum and say that, you know, I have put an assignment, there is a start date to it, there is an end date to it, all this will come, but I am reminding you again about this. So, please go and do it and I am not. So, that is the only way it works, you know, you just tell people again, okay, go to the discussion forum and also, you know, in the activity box, if they log in, so the key is the students need to log in every time. If you log in, it will keep telling you that this thing is due, okay, so that also comes up, but then, you know, the students have to log in and you need to send them a message, and hopefully they have not changed any of the settings. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yes.
I'm Dr. Sharmila from RC1228, Loyola College, Chennai. Mm-hmm. I'm happy to be part of this learning process. I just have a query related to the wiki course portfolio, which is of this week's segment. Okay. And everyone has received multiple reviews, might be say around 10 or 11.
Okay.
And I would like to know how many number of reviews has to be posted.
Okay, so again, this was not what I was going to address, but I have asked this question because a lot of people seem to have asked this question. So there was some kind of a bug there. So technically all of you are supposed to review only 4. So if you review 4 and give it, that should be sufficient. Okay, so some people have gotten 40, I think. So you may have gotten only 10, that is lucky. Of course, you know, if you review more, it is to your benefit. So please don't take it as a burden. But 4 are the minimal requirement for your grade to be assigned. But I would request you, if you can do more, please go ahead. There is no harm in it. Okay, you will only learn more. Thank you.
So actually my question is, how many reviews have we have to post it in our course portfolio?
Okay, I assume that we my asked, answer that should have been 4, but I will reconfirm and tell you. As far as I know, it should have been 4.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. So there are only 5 minutes left. So I would like to tell that right now I am handling only questions regarding week 5 on Moodle. So please don't ask me questions on general administration or the wiki or the screenshots. So please ask me questions which are regarding week 5 and Moodle. There are 5 minutes and I hope you know these are going to be relevant questions.
Sir, how to add a workshop activity on Moodle and how to configure it?
So it is the same thing. You will actually need to, you know, add a resource. So it is one of the resources that you can add. Okay. So as long as you are a teacher, you will be able to do it. So for example, I would just request you for each of these cases that you should go to demo.moodle.net and see a very good, I would say a method or a review on how to do it. So each of these would be a reasonably small module on how they'll explain to you. For example, I have only explained to you a small amount of things which you can do. For example, the assignment and the quiz, which every teacher would want to do. But a workshop is something that if you definitely want peer assessment, it's a very good activity to put it on. I would request you to go to demo.moodle and figure out this for yourself.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yes, good afternoon.
Just to ask one of the questions that due to some reasons, I was not able to do the RC3 activity. So can you please now allow me to do the peer assessment for the same activity?
So again, you know, I will only pass this question on because I don't have the authority to do it. But as far as I have been given to understand, you can do all your submissions because those are required for your pass or no pass grade. You may not get the marks for it, but you have to compulsorily do any of these assignments that you were asked to do. So that is still possible, I think. So you can go ahead. You will just not get marks for it, but you will definitely get the certificates if in the remaining topics you clear everything. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Good afternoon, sir. We are speaking from Central University of Rajasthan. We have a query, sir. Most of the participants, they are lacking of awareness at the initial stage. Not now, okay, they are following Moodle and all these things. So some of them are not attempted initial sentence. So that can you give a chance to once again RC1 and 1 plus 2?
So again, you know, I think I already addressed this. I am not really here to answer this question because it is beyond my domain. But what I have been given to understand is to get your certificate and grade, you have to submit all assignments. So even if the time is passed, you must submit all these assignments. It is just that you may not get marks for it, but that is fine. As long as you get passing marks using the other topics, that is fine. So please go ahead and submit. That should not be a problem. Thank you.
Hello, sir. Some of the participants are telling that they have submitted the assignment, but showing that it is not graded.
I will. If a research problem comes, I will just pass it on to the administrators, and they will see. If you don't think this has been addressed, you can send it via a chat message to the administrators. Thank you.
Hello. Good morning, I am Dr. Monica Sanandan, and my question is on the Moodle quiz. I was trying to attend the Moodle quiz after I had watched the videos, and I find that many of the things that are asked in the quiz are related to the Moodle administrator, editing, etc., which we do not have access to. So we would like to just have little access to that and little more clarification about the IIT Moodle. Because our college Moodle what we use and the one that is there for IIT is a little different.
Okay, so my answer to this is that we are not going to give you any administrator access right now, but if you go to the link that we had provided, demo.moodle.net, it actually allows you to do this, that you can see what kind of administrative responsibility the teacher has. If your Moodle has it, then you know what is going on. So the idea is to go on to the web, search for the information and then answer the quiz. So the videos were only a kind of a trailer to tell you what all is possible. Okay, so I think I did put in the line at the beginning of the quiz that I expect all of you to go on the web and search for it. And if you really want training, then demo.moodle.net is the place to go. In fact, today afternoon the session is for you, all of you, to log on to that site and create a quiz, because I guess unless everyone is told, they don't do it. So this is all available to you for everyone to just go and practice it. So I would advise you to please do that. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, DKT1008.
Hello. A very good afternoon, sir.
Yes.
I please want go to ahead. Ask we can a hear question. You. Can we use Moodle on Android mobile, as we can use it more effectively in class activities?
You want is there a, you mean a mobile version for it? Because definitely you can access the web and use Moodle. Okay, I am not too aware, but as far as I know, there should be a, you know, mobile version for Moodle, but offhand I can't tell you. Let me go and check it and tell you. So that is of course something that you can also check, but probably it is possible to do it. Thank you. 1055.
So this is again is regarding the peer assessment strategies. Peer assessment.
So in the sorry, peer assessment, will, there are certain criteria. Yeah, sorry. I would not really be in a position to answer this question, because I am not, you know, dealing with this peer assessment week. Okay, but if it is regarding how many peer assessments you have to do, then it was 4. If that is what, if you have gotten, let's say, 40 in your mailbox or 10 in your mailbox, it's only 4 if that is what you are most concerned with. But then, you know, I am not too aware of this week's question. I am only looking at week 5 on Moodle.
Okay, so not really about the peer assessment, but see, in peer assessment we are given certain criteria based on which we have to do the assessment. Mm-hmm. And each criteria has 4 levels. But sometimes what I feel is that we have some other basis for which we have to evaluate. Like it is, it's based on the subject, it's based on the course. Sometimes I feel that it's not the 4 levels that is given. Based on that, I have to do an evaluation. So what I do is that if I feel that it's a bad work, then I give whatever is there in the lowest level in that evaluation criteria, and I write the remark in the remarks column. So is it always possible to give a very rigid evaluation criteria for an assessment?
Well, see, this is always going to be very tricky, isn't it? Only some numerical kind of questions you could expect a right or wrong answer. Okay, of course, even in there you can try to figure out how exactly a wrong answer was obtained. But in such a case where you are talking, I agree. I mean, having only 4 or 5 levels when there should be something else, it's very difficult to set it. So if you can make a set of criterion where, you know, you try to build in as much flexibility as possible, I think that would be worth it. Okay, so sometimes, you know, for the lack of time, there may be, you know, you say evaluate it using these four, but you know, I'm sure you can do it with far more than that, but you will have to put in the effort to design it like that. Thank you.
Okay. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, I think last question, because we are now out of time. 1093.
Good afternoon, sir.
Yes.
I am from LDRP, Institute of Technology, Remote Center.
Okay.
My question is related to the Moodle section that you have described. Mm-hmm. That in that, it has been said that essay type question cannot be provided with the feedback instantaneously, but can't we embed the peer assessment with the essay type question in such a way that we ask the essay type question, and then afterward, once that time period is completed, then we can allot this assessment to different students.
Of course, I mean,
and so then that is the possible. Student has to do a constructive assessment.
Correct. So this
is possible to implement that in Moodle?
Yeah. So for example, this would be similar to the workshop kind of activity, and definitely it is possible. It is just that with a numerical question, then and there we can provide an assessment. Okay. For an essay type, you will need someone to read it and then evaluate it and give it. So there is a time lag. So that is all that was asked for. So yes, definitely it is something that you can provide an assessment as fast as possible, depending on, you know, how other participants would be willing to react. Thank you. So yes, that was it. So my time is up now. Thank you.